जय हिंद डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10, वेलकम अगेन इन ज्योग्राफी क्लास। दिस इज धर्मेंद्र मिश्रा। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट थर्ड लेसन इन ज्योग्राफी, वाटर रिसोर्सेस। वाटर इज नो डाउट इज अ प्रेशियस रिसोर्स फॉर अस। विदाउट वाटर वी कांट इमेजिन लाइफ ऑन अर्थ। अर्थ इज द ओनली प्लेनेट हैविंग वाटर ऑन इट। So, life is possible on Earth only. Due to the presence of this water, our Earth seems blue from outer space, obviously called blue planet, also known as watery planet. In this lesson, particularly in class 10, water resources is given to you to understand the importance of it, misuse, and situation where they may water will not be available to the people to survive. So, ultimately, there is a need for conservation. Now see the content given to your book. You already know that 3/4 of the Earth's surface is covered with water. More than 70% land, 70% of the surface of the Earth underwater bodies, right? But only a small proportion of it account for fresh water that can be put to use. We are having ample of water present on the Earth's surface, but do you know it is of two types? Water is saline or salty, and water is fresh also. We use fresh water to survive. Fresh water is needed for agriculture, and fresh water is needed for industries. Everywhere there is use of fresh water, but later I am going to discuss it that this water is very meagre in its quantity. The fresh water is mainly obtained from surface runoff. You know what is surface runoff? After the rain, when the water follows the slope of land and start its journey towards small rills, rivulets, then rivers. This flow on the surface is known as surface runoff. जब जमीन के ऊपर बारिश के बाद पानी बहता है, इसको हम surface runoff कहते हैं. ग्राउंड वाटर दैट इज कॉन्टिन्यूअली बींग रिन्यूड एंड रिचार्ज थ्रू हाइड्रोलॉजिकल साइकिल. यू नो एज वी ऑब्टेन फ्रेश वाटर फ्रॉम रेन एज वेल एज द ग्राउंड वाटर ड्यू टू रेनफॉल, ग्राउंड वाटर टेबल इज ऑल्सो रिचार्ज. Obviously, at our homes, we are using groundwater through the tube wells, borewells, wells. Through these mediums, we are extracting groundwater for our use. All water moves through the hydrological cycle and ensuring that water is your renewable resource. Yes, it is right. Water is your renewable resource. But think, if it is a renewable resource, renewed naturally, then any situation can you imagine that in future there is shortage of it? Or even today, is there any shortage of the water there anywhere? It is really a matter to think, and we need to take some steps for this particular purpose to conservation of water. Water is a renewable resource. Further, you can see, highlighted, you might wonder that if the 3/4 of the world is covered with water, and water is a renewable resource, through the hydrological cycle or water cycle, there is a process of evaporation, condensation, precipitation. All water moves through this hydrological cycle. But the percentage of water in air in form of vapor is very little. But regularly, all water has to move through this hydrological cycle. So this hydrological cycle or water cycle ensure that water is a renewable resource, no doubt. And more than 70% of the Earth's surface is covered with water. Imagine in this condition. How we can imagine that countries and regions around the globe suffer from water scarcity? A new word here you can found. Just see this. Water scarcity. What is water scarcity? Water scarcity is a situation wherein adequate quantity of water is not available to meet its demand or requirement in different uses. Simply, the shortage of water is known as water scarcity. Pani ki kami. There are two situations. Situation of scarcity, where there is lack of anything. Adequacy, where there is sufficient availability of anything. So water is a renewable resource, and besides all, we can see that many regions are suffering, many countries are suffering for water. Water is not available to them, there is a scarcity of it. So water scarcity means the shortage of water to meet the demand of people. Now see the fact, as given, 96.5%, around 97% of total world's water is estimated to exist as oceans, and only about 3% as fresh water. But out of these 3%, 2% are there in ice caps and glaciers. So what is the total percentage of fresh water is remaining for utilize? Out of 100%, only 3% that is called as fresh water, and out of these 2% there in ice cap and glacier. So remaining only 1% water is available to us and fit for human consumption. And these waters are available in rivers, lakes, ponds, underground. And imagine this time, most of the river bodies are polluted, lakes are polluted. Because of increasing pollution, groundwater table is depleting day by day because of excess extraction of water. So in this situation, you can imagine if this 1% precious fresh water will not be conserved, then in future with growing population and demand of water will increase, where from we can fill the demand. So here you can see that the total renewable water resources of India are estimated as 1897 square kilometer per annum. It is too much. India receives a good amount of rainfall. The average rainfall in India is more than 100 cm. We'll discuss later. But we can see in India, some regions, they are suffering from water scarcity, like Western Rajasthan, very semi-arid areas of Gujarat, parts of Deccan Plateau, many times Maharashtra. On the other hand, this water is available in ample, they are in northeastern states, eastern states, where this fresh water through rain becomes a cause for flooding. So it is important to manage these water resources to fulfill the demand of people. We need to utilize the water from those areas where there is surplus of it, and we need to supply it to the regions where there is water scarcity. In this lesson, we are going to discuss all about this. Here it is, you can see, by 2025, it is predicted that large parts of India will join countries or regions having absolute water scarcity. In India today, even you can see there is a long queue in municipality, and there the poor are waiting for their turn to collect a bucket of water. On the other hand, you can see the misuse of this fresh water. Some people are having their borewells, tube wells. They are using this water not only to clean their animals, they are also using to watering over the roads. What is this? This is the misuse. Continuously, they are misusing, who are having too much availability of this fresh water. On the other hand, during summers especially, you can see in newspapers, it is coming every day that many people are suffering, they don't have availability of fresh water. It is a matter to think. You know about our city, Varanasi, located at the bank of River Ganga. It is a perennial river. But during summers in Varanasi, we are facing water scarcity in many parts. What is this? It is the mismanagement of fresh water resources. River Ganga is polluted, second most polluted river of India. Because of polluted water, we are not going to consume it for drinking purpose. So far, there is an urgent need for water resource management. You can see the term given, water scarcity, and the need for water conservation and management. As I have told you, What is water scarcity? Water scarcity is a situation. It is a situation wherein adequate quantity of fresh water is not available to meet the demand of people. Simply shortage of water. Now given here you can see, given abundance and renewability of water, it is difficult to imagine that we may suffer from water scarcity. See this figure. Are you observing this figure? Here given, water everywhere, not a drop to drink. Here it is given, after a heavy downpour, after a heavy rainfall, a boy collects drinking water in Kolkata, life in the city. Here in this situation where rainfall is too much, the main problem is there, that there is none availability of fresh water. So in India, vast areas are flooded every year by the heavy rainfall, but we are unable to manage this fresh water because rain is the main source of fresh water, and they are finally draining into the seas and oceans through the rivers. You can see one point here, it is highlighted that, then observe here in Israel, in Hindi it is given, ek over Israel jaise 25 cm ausat varshik, the average rainfall in Israel is 25 cm. There is no scarcity of water. On the other hand, in India, where the average annual rainfall is more than 100, it means 114 cm given to your book, we are having scarcity of water each and every year. Some regions are facing the problem of drought. Sukha padna bada common hai. Desh mein jal ki upalabdhata aur uske swarup ke anusar samuchit jal prabandhan na hone ke karan hi varsha ka jal nadi nalon, simply after the rain the water follows the slope, and finally through rills, rivulets and small nalaon ke dwara different mal, aur bhi jo isko rills bolte hain, choti nadiyan, sara jal bahke kahan chala jata hai, mukhya nadi mein, aur uske baad mukhya nadi sare varsha jal ko leke samundar mein chali jati hai. So we are unable to manage due to lack of conservation of this precious water resource. There is shortage of it in many parts, and it can be solved with a better management of water resources. Now here you can see a Kashmiri earthquake survivor carries water in the snow in a devastated village. There is snow, that is the fresh form of water, but for water you can see this figure. You can observe, what is this? A long queue is here to collect water. So you can imagine, if you are having availability, imagine about those people who don't have availability of this fresh water. Further given, according to, it is important part you must know. According to Falken Mark, a Swedish expert, he is hydrologist. He is studying about the water resources, their availability, depletion of groundwater, etc. So according to Falken Mark, water stress or scarcity occurs when availability is between 1000 and 1600 cubic meter per person per year. Availability is between, he was Swedish expert, he stated that water stress occurs when water availability is between 1000 and 1600 cubic meter per person per year. So you can imagine, in India this quantity is even not available. So many parts in India we are suffering for water scarcity. Where is there water scarcity likely to occur? Where it can occur? As you read, in a hydrological cycle, fresh water can be obtained directly from precipitation rain, surface runoff and groundwater. But groundwater is also recharged by the rain. It is possible that an area or region may have ample water resources, but it is still facing water scarcity, as in figure you have seen, after a heavy downpour or rainfall. When water is locked over the entire area, the small kid, he was collecting fresh water from the tap. There was a scarcity situation. Suppose lot of water is available, but waters are contaminated, then or polluted, then there is a crisis. There is scarcity. Many of our cities are such examples. In city areas especially, water scarcity is too much. It may be an outcome of large and growing population. It is right. Ever increasing population demands more and more products, not only from agriculture, also from industries, and they consume more and more water. So due to expanding population, water crisis is becoming large and large day by day. A large population means more water, not for domestic use, but to produce more food. Hence, to facilitate higher food grain production, water resources are being exploited and expanded in irrigated areas, as well as now we are doing dry season agriculture. When there is no rainy season, in India, especially in northern plains, which is known as the food bowl of India. In the northern plains, during dry season, we are doing agriculture with the help of tube well irrigation, because boring tube well or bore well, it is very easy in the northern plains, made up of alluvial soil, soft rock is here, groundwater table is quite good, but excess use of it is resulting in depletion of this groundwater table. Earlier, only digging 60 to 65 feet in Punjab, they were getting water in past. Today, they are boring at least 500 feet. Then they are getting water. So, the over-exploitation of water for producing more and more crop to fulfill the demand of increasing population is one of the reasons for water scarcity. There are many causes. First, I have told you over-exploitation. As one example of agriculture I have given. Second, excessive use and unequal access of this water among different social groups. Rich people, they are consuming more water than the poorers. Poor people, downtrodden people, they are suffering a lot because of water scarcity. Third reason, population. Increasing population demand more and more water for domestic purpose even. More and more demand for industrial production is there. As well as urban centers are expanding very fast, require more and more fresh water resources. So, it is another reason, industrialization and rapid urbanization. शहरीकरण तेजी से हो रहा है और शहरों में जल की अवेलेबिलिटी बहुत कम है. Another reason, lesser and erratic rainfall. Sometimes rainfall is less. Monsoon is not equally provide each and every year the same quantity of rain to us. Sometimes monsoon is late and rainfall is lesser as compared to our average 114 cm per annum. Sometimes monsoon is so advanced and sometimes due to excess rain, floods are common situation. So this erratic rainfall, it is very difficult to predict, will occur in sufficient quantity or not. It is one of the reason for water scarcity. In western part of Rajasthan, sometimes 2-3 years where little rain occurs, even rainfall is not taking place for 2-3 years, then suppose how people are suffering there due to water scarcity. They are aware of it, that water is a precious resource. So they are collecting even the rainwater from ancient time to use for drinking purpose, for domestic use, etc. Another reason is modernized and consumption-oriented lifestyle. You can see in cities especially, there are swimming pools where rich people are going to enjoy. Each and every day, lakhs of liters of water drained out from these swimming pools. Again, the fresh water is filled to provide enjoyment facilities for all these poor, rich people. So, there is consumption-oriented lifestyle. If water is available through tap, we are not thinking that how much water is wasting if we are opening the tap regularly and suppose we are doing saving, but tap is open. The water is draining out. It's all consumption-oriented lifestyle. Too much use of water in our daily life is there if it is available. Another reason, groundwater now. As I have told you, groundwater table is depleting day by day. Groundwater table is depleting because of excess extraction of it through the tube wells and bore wells. Besides, excessive disregard for traditional water harvesting system. Do you know, from ancient time, there is a practice of collection of or you can say rain water harvesting there in western Rajasthan. They have collected in past year the rainwater in tanks to utilize as drinking for utilize the water for drinking purpose. But today, due to availability of water through the Rajasthan perennial canal and water supply system, now they are leaving their traditional practice to collect rainwater. So there is a disregard for traditional water harvesting system. Then important is that there it is important to note that we are using a lot of fresh water, not using to satisfy our needs. Sometimes we are wasting it in huge quantity. If you can manage after washing the vegetables, food grains, same water can be utilized for gardening purpose. Never think about this. We are draining it out to the sewage, and again the fresh water we are using for gardening purpose. So this fresh water is wasted, which can be utilized for gardening purpose. It is drained out in sewage. So all these are the reasons or causes for water scarcity. Then now we have to think, as here it was asked that suppose the area is having lot of rainfall, fresh water is available in large quantity, but the area is suffering from water scarcity. So which areas may be affected from water scarcity, or areas affected by water scarcity? One by one I am telling you. First, areas of low rainfall, like the desert areas, semi-desert areas, western Rajasthan I am telling about, Ladakh where rainfall is very less, or desert, Deccan Plateau, especially Maharashtra, parts of Gujarat, parts of western Uttar Pradesh, and some Bundelkhand and Baghelkhand region of the Peninsular Plateau lying in Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. In Uttar Pradesh, you must know that Lalitpur, Banda, Jhansi, these are the regions where water is not available to meet the demand of people. Agriculture is not developed well there due to lack of water. So the areas where rainfall is less, obviously they are affected from water scarcity. Second, areas of over-exploitation. Take the example of Punjab. In Punjab, due to excess use of groundwater, geographically in Punjab, there is no condition for rice cultivation. But with the help of tube wells and bore wells, they are extracting a lot of groundwater, and even before monsoon, they are going to cultivate paddy crops. They are producing a lot of rice, no problem. It is good for food grain production. But on the other hand, they are using a lot of underground water. So the table of underground water is depleting day by day. Bahut kam hote ja raha hai pani ka astar. As I have given an example earlier, after boring only 60-65 feet in Punjab, they were getting fresh water in past, but today they have to dig for at least 500-600 feet deep inside the crust. So what is this? This is areas where the excess use of groundwater is there, they are also facing water scarcity. Third, highly industrialized regions. Industries use huge quantity of fresh water, and where many industries are located, there is overuse of groundwater, overuse of river water even. Do you know all iron and steel plants, they are consuming lot of fresh water for cooling and flashing purpose. And you can see most of the iron and steel plants are located near the river banks, where from the fresh water is available. So industrialization is one hand is good for modernization of economy. On the other hand, excess use of fresh water. Sometimes industries are using groundwater to produce things. Suppose for making soft drinks like Pepsi, Coca-Cola, etc. These industries are utilizing groundwater too much. And because of this excessive use, the groundwater table is depleting day by day. Another region, densely populated regions like cities or the areas where population density is very high, there is maximum use of fresh water. So where density is more, especially the urban centers, there is a crisis of availability of fresh water. So there is shortage, you can say scarcity. Then areas having high irrigation through tubewell, already I have given the example. And the areas having, now suppose there are some areas in Bengal, Assam, where rainfall is enough, groundwater table is quite good, only digging 10 to 15 feet they are getting groundwater, ample water is available to meet the demand of people, but most of the water bodies are polluted or the quality of groundwater is not good. So you can imagine, this is a situation where water is available, no doubt, but the quality of water is not good. Either this is polluted or naturally the quality is not good. So in this condition, they are also facing the problem of water scarcity. So there is need for conservation of water resources. Why it is important to conserve water resources? First reason, to provide water for drinking and other domestic purposes. People are there, they have a lot of demand of fresh water. So if you conserve fresh water through different measures later we'll discuss. So we can provide water for drinking and other domestic purposes. Second, to provide water for irrigation, to produce more and more food crops for food security. If water resources will not be available, what will happen? Production will in agriculture will decrease, and if there is lesser production of food grains, especially in country like India where the population is now reaching up to 130 crore, you can imagine, due to crisis of food grains, there will be a situation of insecurity for food. So to maintain our food security, we need to conserve water. Third, to meet the demand of water throughout the year, where the regions they are suffering from water scarcity, especially during the dry summers. If we conserve these water resources by using many techniques to harvest rainwater and maintain the table of groundwater, we can provide water throughout the year to these regions. Third, to protect water from pollution. It is important part we should understand that it is our duty, moral duty you can say, to conserve water by conserving our water bodies. We need to check pollutants, not tourists, to the water bodies. Fourth, to fulfill the future demands of water, because population is increasing and in future demand will more to satisfy the needs of people that time. From today we have to think regarding the conservation of water resources. Already many programs have started. There are many advertisements are coming from the Ministry of Water Resources that pani ka mol pehchaniye, pani bachaiye, pani hamari jindagi ka sabse mahatvapurna hissa hai, isko bekar mein nasht mat kariye, lot of things. So we can make people aware regarding conservation. If people will be aware, only government is not able to do all such. We need to maintain groundwater table. It is another importance of conserving water. It is important that through conservation we can maintain the groundwater table, because groundwater is the source for use of maximum household in India. Groundwater we are using too much, but on the other hand table is depleting. So it is important to conserve water. We need to dig out some percolation pit, we need to harvest rainwater, say deep inside the crust. In this way we can increase the groundwater table. So conservation is also important to make groundwater table maintained, as well as conservation also can check the flowing of this fresh water towards rivers and seas. Right. So how we can manage these water resources? First, we have to use treated water for gardening, washing vehicles. For these purposes, we can use the water which once it lies, then after treatment, pani saaf hone ke baad, treatment plant se jab bahar aata hai saaf hoke, can be utilized for agricultural purposes. or especially for washing vehicles, toilets, etc. We can utilize this water. We can make people aware about the necessity of this precious resource in our life and to conserve it. We need to register all the water extraction point. How much tea wells are there? How much bore wells are there? We need to maintain our data regarding this so we can check how much extra water is utilized each and every year. Another is, we need to check the pollution of river water. Yes, river, these are the main sources. Taking fresh water from the Himalayan mountains, especially in North India, the river water nowadays mostly polluted. So we need to check pollution of river water. Through this water, we can fulfill the demand of people. Do you know Jamuna is the most polluted river? Yamuna. The most polluted river of India, and that polluted water after treatment is supplied as for drinking purpose there in Delhi. Can you imagine? So people, they are thinking that we can make arrangement of reverse osmosis system called RO. Each and every household which is having enough facility and money, they are affording it, no doubt. But think about the common people. It is our moral duty to check pollution of these water bodies, especially rivers. As well as there is a need for specific steps for different types of regions. What method we have to apply for dry areas will not be the same there in the regions where ample water is available but quality is not good. Like some district of West Bengal, groundwater table is available and it is having a good condition. Groundwater table is not depleted till date, but due to presence of arsenic, many diseases occur because of use of this water. In Brahmaputra Valley, where groundwater table is in good condition, their water can be extracted only digging few feet, but that water contains a lot of iron in it. That is also not fit for human consumption. So, different measures for conservation of water in different regions need to be adopted. Today, I am going to discuss, government has tried a number of things to conserve these water resources, or government has tried to provide these water resources for domestic purpose, industrial purpose, agricultural purpose, etc. Then how? It is not a new word for you, multi-purpose river projects. Multi-purpose river projects, also known as integrated water resource management. What do you mean by the term multi-purpose river projects? The projects in the form of dams. The projects in form of dams on rivers which are serving many purposes simultaneously. Ek se adhik uddesh ke saath nadi jal ka sangrah. The objective is not single. They are the projects which serve many purposes simultaneously. As a dam water can be utilized for irrigation in agriculture, for generating electricity, etc. I'm coming on this point. So, these multi-purpose projects developed by Government of India have helped a lot to provide water to the regions where there is deficit of availability of water, where there is lack of fresh water. Here, question is here, you can see this question. How do we conserve and manage water? I have suggested many points. But do you know from ancient time in India, archaeological and historical records show that from ancient time, we have been constructing sophisticated hydraulic structures like dams, built of stone rubble. In Varanasi, you might have seen many kunds are there called Durga Kund, Lulara Kund, Lakshmi Kund, Pitar Kund, Paras Kund, a number of kunds. Isach Mochan, there is also a kund. Number of kunds are there in Varanasi. Why? Kunds mean kunds means pond that is made up of stone rubbles. Patharon ko taras ke, patharon se tod ke, aur barish ke jal ko ikattha karna. Through kunds. It is a ancient practice in India. In Varanasi, you can see even. Embankment and canal for irrigation. Many examples are there in past even at the time of Chandragupta Maurya, water conservation methods were adopted. So we have continued this tradition in modern India by building dams. This is the modern strategy. By building dams, we can hold back the large quantity of river water in the reservoirs made behind the river banks. नदियों के किनारे पानी इकट्ठा करने के लिए बड़े बड़े reservoirs, dams, you know about these words, dams, we have made it. So in dams, we can collect large quantity of water. Now see, some example of hydraulic structures in ancient India is given. Later we will discuss. But today, we are going to discuss about the dams. What are dams? And how do they help us in conserving and managing water? Dams are traditionally built to impound rivers and rainwater that could be used to irrigate agricultural fields. Dams are the reservoirs made to conserve river water as well as rainwater to provide water for agricultural purposes by developing canals. नहरों की व्यवस्था के द्वारा नहर निकाल के जलाशय, इसको जलाशय बोलते हैं, डैम्स को बड़े जलाशय जलाशय बनाया गया है और इसके पानी को नहरों के द्वारा सिंचाई के लिए ले जाते थे. ट्रेडिशनली वी हैव डेवलप्ड इट टू प्रोवाइड वाटर फॉर इरिगेशन इन एग्रीकल्चरल फील्ड. बट टुडे कैन सी डैम्स आर नॉट बिल्ट ओनली जस्ट फॉर इरिगेशन बट ऑल्सो फॉर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेशन, water supply for domestic and industrial uses, flood control, recreation, inland navigation. Do you know what is inland navigation? If you are constructing deep canals, you can provide small crews and boats to take material from one region to another region. You can provide transport facility to people even. So, in case of multi-purpose projects in India, India failed to achieve this purpose. We have constructed many canals, but all canals are very small, having no water throughout the year. If water is available, the depth of water is not too much. So inland navigation has not developed in India, but fish breeding. So now you can see that there are many purposes behind constructing a dam. First, irrigation. Second, to generate electricity. Third, provide or to development of inland navigation, fish breeding, supplying water for domestic and industrial purpose, development of fisheries, fish breeding, that is, encourage tourism and recreation. Near the dam, the locations are quite picturesque and good, looking good. So people want to go there for picnic. So provide recreation also. So there are many purposes to build a dam, rightly called multi-purpose river projects. Multi-purpose means these dams serve more than one purpose. They serve many purposes simultaneously. So rightly called multi-purpose projects. But these multi-purpose projects have lot of advantages as well as disadvantages. So in next class, we'll discuss about all these. Thank you. Have a nice day.